Christmas come early. Got my tires in. I bought them on two separate, two separate orders, but they both showed up on the same day, which was pretty sweet. Yesterday, we got a bunch of snow, as you saw in my video, if you saw it or not. But I got all my tires same day. It's awesome. I didn't know how they would come. I didn't know if they showed up in boxes or whatever, but they come, I guess, how the same as any other shop would buy them. So, as you can see, it's the Sumig GT55A. I think my stupid thing is too bright. 205/55 R16. 16-inch rims. These should fit my Subaru. If they don't, then I'm out a couple hundred bucks. But they are going to fit. They should fit. Hopefully they fit. So, I'm pretty friggin' excited. Cannot wait to put them on. Yeah, apparently we're not supposed to get snow for like 2 more weeks. But that's cool. I have some time before I have to put them on. Man, look at the tread on that thing. Super deep. Man, I haven't bought new tires since I was like 17 years old. On my third car. I had a 95 Eclipse. You know, it was like that super teal blue green color. I got it in Florida. Put brand new tires on it. Back then, tires, that set of tires was like the same price, like 300 bucks. I must have bought some better than junk tires back then. But these are probably going to do well. These are probably going to do everything I need them to. So excited. Oh, man. Pretty sweet. That car needs a lot of work, and this is just the first little piece of it. I don't think I've done a video addressing it yet, but I'm actually going to pull the motor out of that car again. It's been overheating. I replaced the radiator with a 2.5 RS radiator because I thought that the old radiator from the 2.2 liter was bad, but I don't think that's the case. I replaced the radiator, replaced the thermostat, and it still overheats. So I got to do the head gaskets on this one. It's going to be the exact same as that 98 EJ25D that I did the head gaskets on. But I will probably, I can't say for sure. I'll try to do more videos on the little pieces between it. But I'm going to be in a huge rush doing that head gasket work because I only have like some time between semesters. I'm in school. I have a job. And I'm going to be working my ass off to get that done between that. But yeah, got some tires. I got the rims off that Legacy GT, like I've said lots of times. But the rear driver's side one hit a pothole before I got the car and bent the rim. But for some reason it didn't affect the bead. It just affected just the, I don't know, whatever's outside the bead. It's like the bead, but the tire still holds pressure, so it's not the whole bead, but you can see the crack on it, and I don't know how that's gonna go. If they mess that up, putting the tire on, I will not be very happy. They should be able to do it. They should be able to flip the rim over the other way. If they can't, then they can try to work around that bent part. I hope they can do that. Either using spoons or just good technique or whatever. But I needed to. I can't afford a rim right now. I don't really know where to get those Legacy GT snowflake type rims. I've tried to look on Craigslist, didn't find them, and I don't know anybody that drives Subarus as old as mine that might have one around. Nobody has them, so whatever. So in other news, this project, I am going to sink the carburetors. Where's the thingy? I don't remember. I think it's this hole right here. I think it's that one. If it'll focus, come on, focus. Yeah, that one there. It's a vacuum port. I bought the fittings off of Amazon because to make the brake line fittings where you tap it and put the little screw on it and O-ring and stuff, it's like almost exactly the same price as just buying them made out of brass, well machined, just straight from Amazon. So that's what I did. I got the rubber tubing, and I'm gonna have some bottles set up. I gotta watch some more videos and figure out the fluid people use. Some people use like vegetable oil. Other people
people use ATF, which is a lot thinner. And then I saw one guy use water, but I don't want water in my motor. So I was thinking maybe I should even just use Marvel Mystery Oil if it's thin enough. I mean, if it gets sucked into my motor, that's not going to hurt anything. I mean, that'll help it if anything. But that job, that's going to be a real big pain in the ass for two reasons. I'm going to have to take the tank off to get to the front of my frame that so I can stick a really long screwdriver down in there to reach the sinking screw on the front of my carburetor. That's going to be a bit difficult. I'm going to need external fuel source while it's like, while I have the tank off, suspended above the motor. I mean, I use a bottle or something, gas can, if I can rig it up right, so it doesn't leak or anything. But yeah, by then, after I get that done, this bike should run really well. I really just won't be able to test it because all the roads are covered in snow. I won't be able to test it until it melts off really well. Yeah, I kind of, not even kind of, I want to buy a TIG welder. I take a machining class right now, and it's awesome. And I could get a MIG gun, but I don't really want one. I want a TIG welding setup because it's just easier. They sell, like, Lincoln and Miller, all the popular brands, the really good brands. They sell, like, toaster-size welding, like, TIG welding machines. They're smaller than this one. Smaller than that one, and it uses the same just normal household voltage, 120 volt. So that'll be awesome. But this bike, I think doing this whole bobber thing was kind of a bad idea. Just as soon as I got it like done like this, I had people wanting to ride with me. So I'm going to build a little subframe for it and probably some kind of sweet little sissy bar. And then I'm going to improve the license plate bracket. If I'm going to be doing that, I'll just mount the bracket on there. I'll have to relocate my brake light, which I'll just reuse that one. Probably stick it up high on the sissy bar. And I cut off the passenger pegs, so I'm going to need some more of those. I'm going to build some side covers out of, like, I'd like to use aluminum, but I won't have the setup to TIG weld that. I'm just going to go with a straight steel one. Steel, I think steel and stainless steel are closer than steel and aluminum for setup, so I'll be able to do those too. But I'm gonna do, like, you know, mesh, like a mesh thing that covers this, and like a border, and then maybe some support pieces in the middle just to look cool. I'm not sure how I'm gonna attach it yet, but if I have a welder, I might just cut the whole airbox and junk out of that. And okay, so that's a separate thing. So, yeah, I'll do the covers. I'll make me some side covers. I'll probably put this cover back on because it looks less than cool, less than ideal. I mean, I actually forgot where that side cover is, but it's chrome that I tried to paint like this stuff as well. It's like underbody coating for trucks. Does not work very well when you try to put it on top of chrome. Even though I scratched the crap out of that chrome, intending for the paint to stick, it still didn't want to. It just smeared right off. It was really disappointing. And I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to do with it now. I might just try to maybe just get it down to the metal, like all the way through the chrome down to the steel, and then just polish it and then clear coat over that and then just leave it. Because I don't think painting it will work. But what I was going to say a minute ago, if and when I get a TIG welding setup, I may try to build myself a plenum to get a single carburetor. I've seen people do it, and they said it runs well. It has hardly any drawbacks. They say fuel mileage is an issue sometimes, but not all the time. But if I build that, it'll be so much easier. I won't have to sink the bike anymore. All I have to worry about is like just the single carburetor, and you don't have to sink that because there's only one. I think that's the same setup the Harleys have. I really just want something that'll be easy access, and good. But actually, looking at this, I'm going to have to probably raise the tank a bit, because it'll stick out like this. It'll stick out over here, unless it fits up under there, but I don't think I have enough space in there. You can see the right side carb there. But I think those are the 32. It's either 32 or 41 something. It's in that range. Millimeter carburetors. And I think people go up to a 51 to compensate for both of them. They use one long runner track that rides between both intakes. And then they have the little, the 45s or whatever degrees that go down into each head. So, yeah. That'll be fun. I really want a TIG welder. Anybody watching this wants to buy me one for Christmas? Be much appreciated. I can get you a high five or something. Something in my budget. But yeah, this overall shop update. This bike, awesome. R6, it's dirty as crap because I rode it in the wet right before it snowed. And I didn't clean it. Bad me, I know. The other day, I rode it to work, and it just rolled over to 24,000 miles, and it's still running awesome. Shit, we did a 5-hour ride the other day. Average speed of 70 or so, maybe higher than that. Average speed. I mean, I know I got it up to 150 at one point, and it did well. No drawbacks. Actually, yeah, one drawback. I need a new chain and sprocket set real bad. This one is real bad. It's really, really loose and it's really, really dry. I assume the sprockets are worn a bit. Let's look. Yeah, you can tell they're kind of peeking a little bit. Peeking. They're kind of too sharp. But I'll get a set. I'll get the stock set. I'm going to keep the 530 chain instead of doing like 520 swap or whatever people do. I'll just keep that because it's easier. Easier, cheaper, less to worry about down the road. I can just refer to the stock settings, and that's all I need it for. Because that bike is awesome. It's a really good commuter, and then it's a toy too, so it's awesome. But I really want the Shadow to run, because that would be so much better. That 5-hour ride was awesome on this bike, only because we were doing twisties, mountains, speed. It was an exhilarating ride, but for long distance, longer than that, full day rides or two multiple day rides, this is what I'll need. I have the front fender I'm going to put back on it. I'm going to actually try to get some kind of stupid windshield for this. I don't know if I'm going to build it, put like some vertical thing I could do to cover up the speedometer and stuff, or if I really just want to save up and buy one of those Batwing style. I think if I don't get a radio and all that extra junk in it, it'll be way, way cheaper, and I could just throw it on this and then have my wind protection. And then I'm going to try to reuse the seats, the original seats. I'm going to take this off. Maybe. The pan keeps all of the electronics from getting water and stuff on it, so that's pretty cool. There's a fuse box in there. Actually, the fuse box is on the side, so whatever. But yeah, the bike is good to go. Everything I've done to it is like brand new, except for the mileage. I think it has 30,000, 30,586 miles on that one. But yeah, this video is almost 15 minutes long. Who would want to watch this shit? Video over.